Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to make some crispy chicken keema cutlets. If you want, you can make these using beef as well. So let's see what we'll need to make these cutlets. To begin with, we need to cook the keema. We'll add some oil in a pan over a medium flame. Once the oil is hot, we'll add in one medium-sized chopped onion. We'll cook the onions till they are nice and soft, and in between we'll add some masalas as well to it. We'll add about 4 to 5 chopped garlic cloves. Give this all a good mix. Once the onions have slightly changed color, we'll add 1 chopped green chili. If you want it more spicy, you can always add more chilies. Give this all a good mix. We'll now add in 1 teaspoon ginger garlic paste. Give this a good mix. It's now time to add the powdered spices. So we lower the flame and we add in the turmeric. About 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder. 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. And 1 teaspoon of coriander powder. Give this all a good mix and ensure your flame is low or your spices will burn. We'll now add in 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper powder. Give this a mix and saute the masalas with the onions. We now add in some salt. Once again, give this a good mix. The onions are soft now and the masalas are well cooked, so it's time to add the keema. The flame needs to be on medium now. You need to coat the keema well with all the masalas, so ensure that you give this a good mix. The keema will start releasing water, so you need to cook this till it's completely dry and well cooked. Our keema has been cooking for the last 2 to 3 minutes, so at this stage, if you want, you can add 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala as well. The garam masala is optional, but it does give a good flavor to the dish. It's been about 10 to 12 minutes and our keema is almost ready now, so we add in some coriander. Give this a good mix. I'm tasting the keema now and I feel it requires some more salt, so I'll be adding a little bit of salt to it. You can adjust salt as per your taste. Our keema has been cooking for 15 to 20 minutes now. It's completely dry and well cooked. So now it's time to move to the next step, which is the making of the cutlet. I've let the keema cool down for a bit and now I'm going to add it into a bowl. We now add the boiled potatoes to the keema. Before adding the potatoes, you need to mash them well and ensure there are no lumps in the potatoes. Give this a good mix. We need something to bind this mixture, so I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of breadcrumbs to it. Give all of this a good mix. As you can see, the mixture is not sticking to my hand, so now we are ready to make the cutlets. Take a little bit of the mixture in your hand and start shaping these into cutlets. Combine this well and flatten it a bit so that they cook evenly. Our cutlet is ready. We'll do this similarly for the entire mixture. We now need to crumb the cutlet, so we add this to some beaten egg. Let any excess egg just drop off, and now we add this to the crumbs. Coat the cutlet well on all sides with the breadcrumbs. We'll do this one by one for all the cutlets. Our cutlets are now ready to be fried. So we'll add some oil into a pan. Flame can be between low to medium. If your flame is too high, your breadcrumbs will burn. Once the oil is hot, we'll add in the cutlets one by one into the pan. This won't take too long. It'll take about 2 to 3 minutes on each side, and our cutlets will be perfectly crisp. It's been about 3 minutes or so I'll now flip over the cutlets so that the other side can cook as well. We have a nice golden brown color on one side, and that's the color we want on the other side as well. We've been cooking the cutlets for 5 to 6 minutes now, so they are perfectly crisp and they're ready. Serve these hot with some ketchup or some sweet chili sauce. I hope you like this video and do try this recipe. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and do press the bell icon for notifications.